Hi, everyone. I'm meteorologist Jared Heil with a video weather blog update for you here at WLKY.com. Getting you the latest information here on the possible wintry weather on our forecast, including cold temperatures and maybe a winter storm over the next 7 days to come somewhere in the Ohio Valley. So a lot to talk about. Let's get to it right here. The bitter cold is going to get here late Monday into our Tuesday. Also, a winter storm may affect the Midwest Thursday and Friday. After that, guess what? It gets cold again next weekend. And we may actually finish off this month warmer and stormy across this part of the world as this up and down roller coaster weather pattern continues. Strong low pressure right along the Canadian-U.S. border, two frontal systems with it. The second one has the really cold air, the first one just a little bit cooler, closer to seasonal averages, and that's what's going to get here for tomorrow. So cooler for your Sunday, and then forget about anything cool. It's going to be downright cold for your Monday and Tuesday, because look at the air behind this second push across Canada. We're talking about well below zero readings across southern Canada, farther north into the northern territories, 30s below zero. And when you add in the wind chill factors are anywhere from 20 to 70 below in parts of Canada right now. So put a north breeze on that, send that south, and that means, yeah, some very cold weather is going to head our way as we head into the next several days to come. Here are the details on this Arctic outbreak we're expecting. For Monday, highs around 30 degrees. That will happen around noon. Then temps will fall in the afternoon. Breezes pick up. We'll see wind chills in the teens. Monday night and Tuesday, the coldest air gets here. That's when wind chills fall around zero by Tuesday morning. So be very careful as you head off to work and school at that time. Then by our Tuesday night, a few snowflakes are possible with little, if any, accumulation on that system. So as you're heading out this evening and tonight, the temperature's falling back toward 37 in the morning, only rising to near 40 by tomorrow. So that temperature forecast going downhill in a hurry over the next few days as we have this cold front passing through the area. But what about that second thing we were talking about, the possibility of a winter storm system heading over by our Thursday and Friday? Well, here are a couple of forecast models for you as we head into Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Notice we have the isobars, those are the areas of low and high pressure on the map. And also here we have those shades of gray and blue and even pink there when it's heavy enough, that snowfall accumulation. So this is the European model for the storm system heading our way by our Thursday night and Friday morning. And watch what happens. The low pressure gains strength over Arkansas and moves up through Kentucky. This is a pretty good track for us to see some light to moderate snow across this part of the country. And that's a 3 to 5 inch accumulation of snow, according to this model, 1 to 3 inches in light blue and even 6 inches plus in that darker shade of blue in Ohio. So this model would give us a healthy coating of snow by Thursday night and Friday morning. Here's the fly in the ointment, though. There's always one, right? Across this part of the country, other models are not agreeing yet. This model, the GFS, takes that surface low farther north right across the Ohio River Valley, sends the cold air packing, and we see the heavy snow across the lakes. What's going to happen, right? That's what our job is to figure out. And at this point, I'm starting to lean on the side of the colder solution, because keep in mind it's going to be so darn chilly around here by our Tuesday and Tuesday night that it's going to take a long time to get that dense cold air off toward the north and out of our region. So I think the chances of us seeing some sort of wintry precip look fairly high from Thursday into our Friday. So keep that in mind, and we'll update you on that, of course, the next several days here. Here is the upper-level jet stream pattern. You can see across this part of the country, we're in that dip in the jet stream with the extreme cold in eastern Canada, but we're far enough north here in the Ohio Valley to see those southern reaches of that Arctic air mass by Tuesday morning. There's the clock for you. The warm weather is off toward the west, where highs are in the 70s and 80s across the state of California. Wouldn't that be nice? Then by our Friday, we'll see that second storm system passing by in some form or fashion. It will get colder again behind that storm with highs in the 20s on our forecast by a week from now on Saturday. And then watch what happens. We'll get that system out of here. That's going to mean more wintry weather on the far east coast. But look what happens out here on the west coast. Instead of the big ridge we were talking about, they have a trough of low pressure across the western part of the country. And that means off in this part of the world, warming temperatures, because what goes up must come down and vice versa. So we'll see a warming trend by the end of next weekend into early next week, I do believe, as the west coast turns colder. What does this storm system do? That's what may bring us a bout of wet and stormy weather toward the end of the month before it turns colder again in February. And by the way, February still looks very cold across the Ohio Valley based on the latest model projections. We'll update those for you the next several days here at WLKY.com. I'm Jared Heil, WLKY TV. Have a great night.